Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. I'm joined by Mark Gasson. He's a director at Rome Resources. Mark, very good to meet you.
Good afternoon, Stefan. And yeah, thanks for the opportunity of having this chat.
Oh, you're welcome, Mark. So for you viewers not familiar with the company, tell us more about Rome Resources.
Okay, so Rome Resources was reinstated onto the TSX Venture Exchange in November last year. At the same time, they had signed agreements to own 51% of the Bisie North Tin Project, which is in the high-grade tin province in the Walikale area in eastern DRC. The project itself lies within 8 kilometers of Alphamin's Mpama North mine. Alphamin today is a billion-dollar company. And they have the highest grade tin deposit in the world at a grade of 4.5%. The same technical team that discovered the Alphamin deposits is now working for Rome. That includes myself and Jamie Anderson, who is the exploration manager. So we, you know, as a team, we are fully aware, very familiar with the geology. And we understand where, you know, how these structures work. What's important as well is that Alphamin's Bisie project sits on a structure which lies adjacent to the source granites. The same structure is interpreted to continue all the way northwards around the granites and where they bend when they flex around the granites on our project. We're on this flexure point, that is where we have found this intense soil anomaly, 5 kilometers long, and up to sort of 1.2 kilometers width in its broadest portion. Within that 5 kilometer soil anomaly, you have 3 kilometers of really high grade tin in the soils, and so we have focused on three main target areas within that soil anomaly: the Mont Agoma anomaly, which is purely a pure discovery with no artisanal workings, and we have very high grade soil anomalies that have we're getting up to sort of 0.3% tin in the soils, which is pretty much unheard of. The other two projects, the other two targets, the one had historic artisanal workings, but conditions weren't conducive, too much water, so they left and went to the easier Kali target. And there we channel sampled some of their workings, and we found up to 1 meter running at 11% tin within a broader sort of 10 meter wide zone.
In fact, Mark, you're out with new results from maiden drilling on the program. When would you expect the assays for those test results, and how encouraged are you by what you're seeing?
Okay, so we are very encouraged from what we're seeing. Basically, the first lab results will be coming out in the middle of April. But in the meantime, we have done our own Niton XRF analyses on the pulps from the sample prep lab, and we've got the confidence and we can define where the zones are. But we need to just wait for the results from the laboratory before we, you know, announce the actual grades of the intercepts.
Mark, you announced a capital raise up to $3 million Canadian dollars. That was earlier this month. How will that place you to take the project forward?
Okay, so the $3 million will take us forward for the next sort of 4 to 6 months. And during that period, we hope to have a lot more results and a lot more core. We'll be in a much better position to understand what's the potential of the project, basically, and at that stage we would go in and raise a much bigger amount.
Mark, I hope you can keep us posted on any developments at the project. Thank you very much for the introduction today.
Thank you very much, Stefan.
Mark Gasson is Director at Rome Resources.